Today, we're exploring a brand new AI coding tool called MGX Dev. It has a collection of 5 different AI agents working together to build your project. These 5 AI agents are a team leader, a data engineer, an engineer, a product manager, and an architect. They're working together to make sure that they're developing exactly what you're asking to develop. I will guide you through the process of how this tool looks like, how to tag different engineers to do different tasks and make sure that you're getting the best outcome possible. And also, we're going to be building our own tool just to test it out and see how it looks like. With that being said, I will ask you to please consider liking this video, tell the algorithm that this video is worth watching, and it will push it out there for others to watch. Other than that, let's jump in and let's start building. All right, and this is MGX, similar to other AI coding tools. You have an input field here, you have some suggestions. On this one, you can actually select which model you're going to be using. We're going to select Claude on 3.7 Sonnet just for this demo. But I want to show you some of the demos that I have seen for MGX that actually I really liked. The first one is at Texas Hold'em Poker. And this is a poker table. I want to refresh this. I was playing a little bit. We're going to have 3 players. And, you know, you're going to play. The AI is actually going through. I don't really know how to play poker, but it seems like I have a decent chance. Or maybe not. I don't know. But this was created using MGX. And as you can see, it has the MGX URL at the end. Then you have a stock analysis chart. This doesn't have live data, but I really like the layout and how it looks. You get prices and you have a cumulative return, and that's pretty cool. You can change the time period that it covers. This is pretty nice. Then you have a Minecraft game, which you can move around and actually play. It's pretty cool. Yeah, so you can build blocks and delete blocks just like in Minecraft. This is really nice. If you're looking to build a video game, MGX might be something to consider. Then you have a task manager here, and it allows you to track a lot of data. This person actually created a lot of the tabs that you will be using. Pretty nice. I really like what I'm seeing here. Then we have an LLM ranking. Again, really well thought out design. The AI did a really good job. I really like what I'm seeing. Perhaps this is not the most advanced design in the world, but it's really nice for an alpha version. So I'm going to say that I give them A- for execution of the design. But let's take a look at what you can actually build. I'm going to bring in a prompt that I already have, and we're going to talk about what we can build and how we go about building in this new tool. All right, and now we have the prompt. What I'm going to do is paste it here. And just to give you a quick breakdown of what we're going to be doing, we're building a platform which in the future will use AI. The idea is it will allow users to explore certain cities or neighborhoods to find which are the best based on different criteria like school ratings, crime rates, neighborhood average prices. The houses are available in the market and they are decidable for the user, and other relevant data that perhaps I'm not seeing right now and AI can decipher for me. So we're going to send this, and as we're going through it, I'm going to guide you through what is going on. Right now, my team leader is analyzing the requirements and he's trying to figure out who he is going to task with doing what. So you get Emma, who is the product manager. You got David, who is the data analyst. Right now, David is collecting and analyzing the data for Austin neighborhoods. I'm assuming that data would be passed on to either Emma or Bob to work on the design. Emma is the product manager, Bob is the architect, and lastly, Alice is the engineer who is going to be writing the code. I have a feeling that Alice is going to be doing the heavy load on the back end, making sure we have the website we want built in terms of the data that we're looking for those neighborhoods. We're going to see how long this takes. Let's see. So this is live. So it's thinking through the process. It's looking at the average home prices. It continues collecting the data. Keep in mind that MGS is not connected to the internet, so the data might be a little bit on the older side. Also, we're focusing our project in Austin, Texas. So Austin and the surrounding suburbs. So perhaps that gives you a little bit of context as for exactly how it's going to get built. So right now he's organizing the collected data in comprehensive JSON format. And that's great because that's probably the format that all the other agents are going to need in order to make sure that it can be built and it can be seen. Also, just for transparency, I am on the free plan. So I don't know how far we're going to get. We have 750,000 tokens. Hopefully that's enough to be able to build an initial version of this project. But I wanted to be upfront with you because if we don't get to build the full vision, the reason why is because I'm on the free plan and I'm showcasing exactly what you're going to be getting with the free plan and how far you can get. I use it yesterday night. You have up to 2.5 million tokens free per month, 750,000 per day, which is more than enough. It's actually a lot, if you think about it, that you're getting for free out of this AI coding tool. Now, the data has been passed to Mike, and Mike is talking with. All right, so he does Alice, who is the engineer, to actually develop a minimalistic premium web application, which is basically the instruction that it provided. Alice is going to start working on that. I'm not going to connect Supabase because all the data will be static data. So I will steer away from using Supabase. I also want to save some tokens. So hopefully we can get far enough. I will show you a few things as the AI system get towards the end of this build. So you get a better idea of how you can make it work. You can upload files or folders. If you already have code from a different tool and use it as a starting point, you can upload files like images to use as inspiration. You can also change which LLM model you're going to be using for your project. If you look up here, you got your chat history. I was working on a CRM. I'm working on the Neighborhood Explorer app. You can go to Upwork, which is where I got those websites that I showed you just a minute ago. You have your configuration. You got your plan, which I'm in the free plan. You can manage your payment. And of course, you can log out. Here you connect Supabase. If you want to share what you have worked on so far, you can do that here. Here is your global controls. You can set up your default model, the chat layout, and so on. All of those settings will be available right there. You can pause the AI. So it stopped building. You got the play speed. I don't really know what that is, to be honest. Follow working agents. I don't know what that is. But you got your terminal right here. You got your planner. This is, you're going to see the tasks that are created by Mike, by David, by Alice, by Emma, or by Bob. Basically, the AI agents are going to create their own tasks. Here, you can see which one is in progress. And once that one is done, there will be another tab here for Alice. You got your notebook. Again, one of those things I'm not completely sure what it is for, but I guess we will discover it as we go. And here are your files. we're going to go back and be waiting for the editor. I got a feeling that we're going to be getting this done relatively soon for version one. It's working on the filter right now. It has a header. It also has the neighborhood card and neighborhood details, like a list of neighborhoods. And we got all the basic implementation and we got the JSON data down here. So it's even adding a map, which is really cool. Blows my mind how nice things this AI coding tool can create for you. So we're going to give it a minute and see what's up in a moment. So it keeps working on the map. I will tell you what, I will pause this video and we will be back in a moment. Let's see where we stand in 2 or 3 minutes. It looked like after a little bit, we have successfully completed the app generation. I'm going to close this pop-up and let's try to see. All right, so it looked like it actually was interrupted. So what's a task for me? Let's take what it will do is we're getting our preview here. It might have been that I didn't realize it was done. Okay, so there's an error. We're going to ask to fix the error. Hopefully. Let me refresh the whole thing. It doesn't look like we can open it. I'm going to open this in a new browser. It's a blank page because we got this error. Or you can continue. All right, we're going to continue. We're going to send this. All right. If you have been using AI coding tools, you know by now that these things happen. You're going to get errors. Bolt used to be really bad about this. You would get 10 different errors in one build just because, but nevertheless, you will be able to get what you need. They have improved a whole lot since then. I actually enjoy using Bolt nowadays. Before, it used to be hit or miss. You will get good project done today. And tomorrow, a different project, it will take you 10, 20 iterations to try to fix an issue. So I am grateful for them fixing all the issues. With that being said, we're going to let MGX fix this issue. I will pause the video again because I want to make sure that I'm not wasting your time watching this and we will be back in a moment. Unfortunately, we have hit our quota for day. Unfortunately, we would have to stop this project here. Now, the biggest takeaways are, number one is actually really cool what you can build with this. At least the experience been pretty nice. Seeing some of the other demos have actually been relatively nice to see what other people are building, and I am impressed. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get my initial version done for you to see, but I think you have seen enough to at least give this a try. And if nothing else, you can start using the free plan. Free plan is fairly generous. Perhaps I was too ambitious on this build, but I have to say that is not one of the best, not the best I have seen, but one of the best that I have seen so far in regards to how it works. This is definitely innovative, seeing all the AI agents working side by side, hand to hand, and see Mike giving Alex and David tasks on what to do, making sure that they are executing what they need to execute. I really like the concept. Now, I will ask you, what do you like about the experience? I know we didn't finish building, my bad, but what do you think? How will you use this tool? Will you give it a try? Let me know down in the comments below. While you're there, please consider liking this video, subscribing to the channel. It helps me out a lot. I think I'm putting great things out there. So please help me with that. With that being said, thank you for watching. I hope to see you on the next video.